In this segment, we're going to take an example of the exponential model of regression. So we have an exponential model which we want to be able to use for regressing to a particular data. And what we're going to do is we're going to use transform data. We're going to use transform data to do so. And we'll talk about a little bit later about what the transform data means. In the previous segment, I already talked the theory about using the transform data to develop the exponential model. So let's talk about the example. The example is about an isotope of technetium, which is used for gallbladder scanning. And an isotope, technetium 99M isotope, is used to be able to do a CT scan of a gallbladder. Now, as we know that this is a radioactive material, so we want to be able to figure out that how long does it take for a person to lose this isotope from the body. The half-life of technetium-99m is about 6 hours, so it doesn't take too long for one to go back to the normal levels of radiation which we get from the sun, for example. So, but let's go and see, figure out for ourselves that if we take the intensity of the isotope versus time data, will we be able to figure out that how much of the isotope is still in the body? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you time, which is in hours, versus relative intensity data. So that's relative intensity. What I mean by relative intensity is that this is the intensity of the isotope when related to what is happening at 0 hours. So what that means is that at zero, the relative intensity will be, of course, 1, because you're dividing by the intensity at time t equals 0. At other points, the data is given to us. At 1, it is 0.891. At 3, it is 0.708. At 5, it is 0.562. At 7, it is 0.447. At 9, it is 0.355. So you're already seeing that around about 6 hours or so, you're losing about half of it. So the half-life is of technetium-99m actually is 6 hours. But let's go and figure out that what happens, what is the relative intensity at 24 hours? Does it go down very low so that the patient is not worried about having radioactive material in their bodies? So what we're going to do is we are going to use the exponential model to be able to figure out what the relative intensity of the technetium isotope is at 24 hours. So we're going to use the exponential model to do the regression. So, but we're going to use the transform data for this. So what that means is that if I have gamma is equal to A e to the power bt, I'm going to transform the data corresponding to this model so that I can use the linear regression formulas. So what does that mean is that I'm going to take the log of both sides, for example, in this case. That's how I'll be able to do the transformation of the data so that I can use the linear regression model. So I get log of gamma is equal to log of A plus BT. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this to be my Z. I'm going to assume this to be my A naught, this to be my A1. That's what I'm going to take, do those substitutions. So if I look at those substitutions, I'll get Z is equal to A0 plus A1 times T. That's what I'm getting. Now, this is a linear relationship between Z and T. As you can see, that it's a straight line or a first-order polynomial relationship between Z and T. Now, what that means is that if I'm able to find Z versus T data, then I'll be able to find A0 and A1. So if I'm able to find A0 and A1, then I can find my log A and B, which B is same as A1, while log of A is equal to A naught, so A would be equal to A naught. So that means that, let's suppose, for example, once I find A naught, log of A is A naught, so A will be e to the power A naught. So that's how I'll be able to find my A. And B is nothing but the value of A1. So that's how I'll be able to find the constants of the exponential model. Keep in again mind that the linear relationship is between Z and T. So in no way should you consider that we are linearizing the model. We're not linearizing the model. All we are doing is transforming the data itself so that there's a linear relationship between Z and T, not between gamma and T, not between the relative intensity and time. It's an exponential model. We are developing, trying to see if there's a linear relationship between Z and T, and from that we can backtrack the constants of the exponential model, which are a and b. So as you can see, that z is equal to log of gamma, which means that what we'll have to do is we'll have to take all the individual gamma values and calculate our zi values to be able to do that. Now, how do I find a naught and a1 of this? A1 will be equal to n times summation zi t sub I minus summation zi summation t sub I divided by n times summation t sub I square minus summation t sub I whole square. So that's the coming from the linear regression formulas. That's what I'm going to use. All these summations are going from 1 to n, so that's why I've not put the limits of the summation here. I should have, but all the limits of the summation are 1 to n, where n is the number of data points which I have. And a naught is nothing but z bar minus a1t bar, where z bar is the average value of the z values, and t bar is the average value of the t values. So that's how I'll be able to find a1 and a naught from the z versus t data. And then I'll be able to find a and b, which are the constants of the exponential model, from the values of a naught and a1, which I find from the linear regression formulas here. So I'm going to draw a table so that I can calculate these zi values, which are the values which I need from the original data. So I'm going to calculate the zi values, and then also I'm going to develop a table so that I can show the summations which I need. I need the summation of z sub I, t sub I, summation of z sub I, summation of t sub I, and summation of t sub I squared. That's what I need.